before I bring my testimony, I will just say, because I know that Jacob's asked me to, and I'll forget. The item will be a little bit delayed. That will be part of the presentation that's coming. So my testimony starts when I was quite young. I remember my dad coming to the Lord. I remember he came home and started telling us about miracles, started telling us that he found the truth that was in the Bible and that there was a personal experience that he could have with God. I distinctly remember him saying that you didn't just automatically go to heaven when you die, you actually need to get yourself right with God, and Jesus was coming back. And that was a new conversation topic in our family. We didn't really talk about God or any of those sort of issues at all. And when I look back on it, Mum and Dad were starting to live quite separate lives. My dad, he worked all week and Saturday mornings, and then he was in a band on the weekends, and so he would be having band practice after work during the week and then going off and doing that. And Mum had a sport, and she would drag us all to netball. And that was, as a child, you don't know anything else. But I do remember this big change that happened in my dad. And when he stopped playing in bands, he gave all that up, because that was something he was pursuing, an emptiness that he had inside that the Holy Ghost had filled. So he started going along to this this church, and that was something that I could go along to as well. So he took us along to a meeting. My mum was quite against it at that stage, and in case also I forget to say that she did eventually come to the Lord later. But at that time, she was quite against it. And so often I would just go to the meetings with my dad. And I remember that people there, they actually knew God. Like, they seemed to know what they were talking about, and they were excited about it. And everyone had a story, and we'd go to someone's house, and they would just share testimonies and just talk about God. And I just loved it. And I think I just always wanted to be a good girl, always wanted to do the right thing, and I felt like I constantly failed at that. And I just wondered where it was all heading. And then when my dad came to the Lord, that there were answers for all of these questions, answers for the big questions about where you went when you died and what happened. And it just, it was the truth. And I just wanted that power that people had at that time. So I came to understand that difference that I saw in the people, that was the Holy Spirit. I just wanted what people had. I saw in that a power to be a good person and do the right thing, because I heard these amazing stories. And over time I came to understand that this was how God sealed you, that he was your father, and that he was coming back to get you. And so after maybe 6-7 months, I was praying with my dad and another brother, and started speaking in tongues, and from then I knew that I had that evidence from God. He connected with me, and he had changed the course of my life from that point on. And I was so relieved. It was early 90s, so Gulf War time in Iraq, and we thought this was it. And so it was just such a relief to have that peace, to know that God was coming back for me, and I was going to be safe. And I could see at that time that all the big questions that I had an answer. I had a source of truth for all the things that were going to happen in my life from then on. So although I was 9 years old, I was quite young, but I saw a difference in my life before I came to know the Lord and after. And so really praise the Lord for that, because that gave me a direction and something to fall on as I went and grew up. And At that time, I got baptized by full immersion. 3 days after I received the Holy Spirit, I couldn't wait to do that because I could see in the scriptures that that's what I needed to do, and I'm just so happy to do it. In that time, my mum had come to the Lord and seen her healed of migraine headaches. And as I mentioned, the changes in my dad, and he had a healing of arthritis in his shoulders, and we just started a new life. We just came together as a family in a new direction, and when things came against us, we could pray, we could seek the Lord and expect an answer, and that has been what my life has been like ever since. And now I'm a wife and mother as well, and it hasn't changed. And situations change, but the Lord is the source of the answer for all of those things, and it's just overwhelming, I think. And you know, we've just been and seen some of the amazing natural beauty that there is in this country, and there are hundreds, thousands of people there also experiencing that, and you think, how many of them actually know the creator, the designer of all these things, and what an honor it is that we have that personal connection with him. And this is the bit where I always get stuck, because there are so many things I can't think of what to say about the miracles that have happened, but to be able to bring up children in the Lord and have that anchor for your soul and that shelter for the people around you is just an amazing blessing. Both of my children can tell their own stories of how they've been healed, and a little bit later on to share a little bit of what we've seen in the work that's done in the Solomon Islands. And I can't believe that I've been able to be, you know, to see that firsthand, to witness that. I'm not that sort of person to go out on those sort of adventures, but somehow the Lord, he picks the most unlikely people and says, just watch this, just watch what I can do. And I was thanking for his direction and provision and the hope that we have, the real sure hope that we have for the future.